Sabhanayaka Natarajan temple in the town of Chidambaram. Don't confuse him with that corrupt man who's been going to jail recently. That town has nothing to do. Chidambaram just means Shiva. So, in the town of Chidambaram, there's a very famous temple called Nataraj Temple. And the DMK government took it over. And having taken it over, the first thing they did is they opened samosa stalls, liquor bottles were being sold, all inside the temple campus. So the pujaris, they were called dikshitas, they came to me. And Swami Dayanand Saraswati and other Swamijis told me, you must take this up. So I filed a case in the Supreme Court. And the Supreme Court gave a judgment in 2014 stating that this takeover of the temple was not based on any logical basis. The only basis it could have been taken over is for financial mismanagement, and no records are made available by the government to show there was financial mismanagement. It seems to have been done for political motivation, and they then cancelled the order of the GO of the government and returned the temple to the pujaris. They also said something which I had raised supplementary, that government is no business to run temples. So if they take over a temple because of financial management, it has to be for a short period. I said 3 years to clean up an accounts book. Takes only 3 years in my opinion, they said. Court said it can be 5 years. And finally the judgment they put, limited period. That means, according to that judgment of the Supreme Court, which is binding on the whole of India, Tirupati, which has been in the control of the government, in the financial matters, for 86 years, should be immediately freed. But the problem is, after freeing, who to give to? Because in the case of Sabarayaka temple, Nataraj temple, the Dikshitas in the DMK government took it from the Dikshitas. And so it was easy to say, give it back to the Dikshitas. Now after 86 years, who is the person who owned Tirupati, or at least for the people who built the Tirupati Tirumala temple, who should be the trustees of that temple? That problem has not yet been solved. I filed a case in the Andhra High Court and made two prayers. First prayer was that for the last several years, money that came into the hundi, money that came into by donations, these were taken over by the government and spent by the government, but there are no accounts for it. They had an officer in the government to do the auditing. And what do you expect an auditor, government within the officer within the government to say that there has been money has been taken away, it's been squandered, or it has been given away to some people who have nothing to do with the temple. So the government reports were, all accounts are fine. But the system is, if a government runs an enterprise, the audit is not done by internal departments, but by a independent outside department, like the Comptroller and Auditor General of India, or some specially drafted consulting company, auditing company, and then get an independent report, and which then should be passed. That has not been done for the last at least 5 years. The evidence have presented a record. So I said the first thing the court must do is give a direction that the auditing of the Tirupati temple for the last 5 years should be placed on the table in the before the High Court. Before this, there was Chandrababu Naidu and he didn't do anything. Now we have a new Chief Minister. He better do it, otherwise I will win. It will go against him. I am asking him to ask the Comptroller General or somebody else, independent, to audit the accounts of the last 5 years and tell us what happened to the money that was given by devotees to the Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam. And that is something which I am hoping to get a result soon. I am getting the news that the government is willing to discuss with this, and then we can go to court. The second thing is, of course, I said, government should get out of Tirupati. But the court asked me, get out and who should run the Tirupati temple? They are only Swamiji's. I am not a real Swami. I am only an ordinary. You are the real Swami. You bring all the Swamiji's together and tell me how Tirupati should be managed, who are the people to whom it should be given to. Like they have a Gurdwaras. They have a Gurdwara Prabandhak committee for which they hold elections. And it is run by the Sikh community, no government interference at all. We can consider some such mechanism, and that is what is left, and that is why the court case is not being listed, because discussions are going on how to do it. And this applies to all the temples in the country. I filed a case for the Devasam board in Kerala, same answer. Yes, we agree that the government has been managing this from 1949. It's too long. It's not the job of the government to run temples. And therefore, the only thing left for me is to say, to whom should it be given? And that is what I am working on. I hope Prakash Rao will hold an international seminar and give us some inputs on how these temples should be now taken over and managed. So therefore, I am saying today to you that we are now entering a new phase where the government will get out of temples. And that means 4 lakh temples. And 4 lakh temples, you take, when they become out of government control, then we have to see what were its properties when they took it over, and what is left today. And so you will find that many politicians have taken over land and given it to builders and so on. We have to catch them also, so that in future nobody would dare to touch our temples. Now, what's so important about a temple? It is not like a church. You just go to the church and hear a sermon and come back. Temple, first of all, is where God resides. That is the meaning of Prana Pratishtha Puja. And God enters the Murti, God can see you, but you can't see God, but you know from our scriptures that God resides in that temple, because in that Murti, because Prana Pratishtha Puja was done. It was built according to Agama Shastras. So therefore, this is a holy place. A masjid is not a holy place. It is a place to read namaz. And namaz can be read anywhere. They will read namaz on the road. They will read namaz in the drawing room. They read namaz on the railway platform. They read namaz on the aeroplane. So, when this Ram Mandir case came up, I said it is not an equal contest between Ram Mandir and a masjid. And if you look at the prayer of Sunni Waqf Board, they are not saying that Baba built this masjid and so we want oh, we want to rebuild the masjid. They are not saying that. They are saying the land is belonging to the Sunni Waqf board.